And now next up, we have Venezuela versus Philippines.
Bueno, buenas noches o buenos días, depende de qué parte del mundo se encuentren. Vengo a hablarles sobre mi proyecto. He trabajado con diferentes causas sociales en mi país, he tenido la oportunidad de presentarme en muchos lugares, en muchas regiones muy humildes, que requieren de mucha atención y en búsqueda de una causa real importante y que dejase una huella en el paso del tiempo. Me conseguí con una madre que estaba muy triste, me contó que no podía darle la bendición a su hija, que estaba fuera del país. En Venezuela ya sabemos que muchas personas están emigrando, aproximadamente 4 millones de personas se han ido en los últimos 10 años en mi país y en los dos últimos años, de 2015 a 2017, han migrado aproximadamente 1.622.000 personas. En Venezuela en este momento no tenemos roaming internacional, no nos podemos comunicar con las personas que están afuera, a de no ser que tengamos un teléfono inteligente, y muchas personas de muy bajos recursos no lo tienen, y es por eso que yo decidí y pensé en crear una plataforma de comunicación que trabaja con un asistente de voz. Este asistente de voz es una plataforma absolutamente satelital y sería para que estas personas que están dentro de Venezuela se puedan comunicar con sus familiares que están en el exterior, porque cuando esta señora me dijo que no le podía dar la bendición a su hija, nosotros sabemos los latinos lo que significa para nosotros que nos digan la bendición. Papá y mamá te dan la bendición cuando estás triste, cuando te levantas, cuando te vas a dormir, en cualquier momento importante de tu vida. Y qué triste que muchos venezolanos hoy día no lo tengan. Y es por eso que quiero crear una plataforma de comunicación para todos aquellos que están fuera. Gracias.
Hi everyone, I'm really happy to be here and to share with you my Beauty with a Purpose project, which is about peace education. So the UN created 17 Sustainable Development Goals towards a better world. And the 16th is peace and strong intuition. So I partnered with an NGO that was founded in Marawi City in the Philippines called the Teach Peace, Build Peace Movement. And peace education is pretty much, I don't know if you guys remember in school learning, like the golden rule when you're like 5 years old, 6 years old, or like anti-bullying programs, or you hear your teachers say, if you have nothing nice to say, say nothing at all, right? Well, after some point, we stop hearing that. And peace education actually teaches children and the youth why we should practice these things. It teaches children and the youth how to pretty much navigate through different uncomfortable situations, like arguments with one another. It, in a nutshell, teaches that although we may not be brothers and sisters in culture, religion, blood, tradition, we are brothers and sisters in humanity. And starting with the children and youth and having this implemented in the school curriculum, informally and formally, will definitely help prevent situations like war, violence. And I think the most beautiful thing I've learned about all of you ladies and the advocacies you've shared with me is that peace education can help. It can help with, for example, self-peace, like Miss Scotland's advocacy of suicide or the, oh, thank you. That's it.
Thank you very much, Venezuela and Philippines. Over to you, Frankie.
Thank you, ladies, both very much. Philippines, you were out of time, so we had to stop you, but excellent answers from both of you. And a great example that regardless of what language you speak, presentation skills really transcends all languages. So the judges have made their decision, and we're going to start off on the other end with Megan Young.
Yes, like Frankie said, language is not a barrier here. It's about how you present your project. And between the two of you, my choice is Philippines.
I'd say that, Ms. Philippines, I'd love to know more about your project, but we ran out of time, which is why Venezuela.
As the one of the three judges that understood the both of you, it's actually a very difficult call. But I think I'm gonna have to give it to Venezuela.
Congratulations, Venezuela. You have made the Miss World Final 30. You must be ecstatic.
Happy, no? Feliz? No voy a hablar inglés.
And unfortunately for you, Philippines, you did run out of time with your question.
I did. I had a lot to say. I think it's a very broad topic, and I just want everyone to understand it. But no worries. At least I got to share my beauty with a purpose to everyone.
Well, commiserations. And there is another opportunity for you to make the final 30 on the Miss World Final. Congratulations, ladies. You can take a seat.